I've always enjoyed those comedies where very proper British ladies are put in horribly outlandish situations. And tonight, for our first presentation of Potluck Playhouse, we would like to present to you Not So Private Lives. It's a fearfully good script, and I'd like you to join in if you jolly well stay where you are.
Why not? You're ruining my business. When we got married, you said you were going to help to run this bar with me.
Well,
what are you doing? All you're doing is running it into the ground, into the ground.
Ernest, dear, I know it's an appalling situation, but I don't know what to do.
Can I give you a hint? The first thing you got to do is get rid of that English accent. How many times do I have to tell you? You're Puerto Rican.
Ernest, be serious.
All right. I really want to get started. You gotta help me in this business. Move that booze. Push that juice. Hustle that sauce.
Oh, should I do it? Try, darling.
Oh, I know. But you're too slow. A drunk could pass away at the table and put two shots in his eyes before you know what's going on.
Oh, yes, I adore you, but I absolutely cannot push drinks and act cheap.
That's your trouble, Cecily. That's your trouble. You think you're too good for this place. How many times do I have to tell you? You have to mingle with the riffraff and dance with the sailors.
But I couldn't possibly do all that.
All right, then I'll meet you halfway. You mingle with the riffraff, and I'll dance with the sailors. Now, let's hurry it up, huh? I got a petty officer that wants to do the Lindy Hop with me. I'm so lonely.
Clive, now listen, please tell me. What did I do wrong? Tell me.
Portia, please, you're blocking my garbage.
I know you think I flirt with the customers, but I don't. Really, I don't.
Don't lie to me. You have a gimpy little slink.
Well, that's not a gimpy little slink. I'm on my feet so much, I dislocated my hip.
Portia, do you take me for a dupe? Is it enough that you're an insatiable strumpet and I am an unsullied cuckold?
Oh, Clive, you talk so pretty.
Portia, why can't you profit by my example? Why do you call our pate goose grease? Why do you refer to our rump roast as butt stick? Why do you allude to our hors d'oeuvres as a nosh?
Well, I'll try to do better. Honest, I will, Clive.
Well, you're going to have to. Now, get back in there and listen. Don't serve them anything that isn't on the menu. Right, the shredded sponge, the half-eaten sandwich, the corduroy knickers.
Yes, tell me, how are the children?
The children? I thought they were with you. But tell me, what are you doing in this godforsaken home?
It's a long story, Clive, and I'm sure you don't want to hear about it. But it all started the day that you deserted me in the desert.
Yes, you're right. I don't want to hear it.
No, of course you don't. Oh, Clive, don't you hear what you're saying? Don't you see what you've said? Don't you feel what you're knowing? Can't you say what I've seen?
Of course I could, but then I'd be hearing what you're saying and seeing what you've said and seeing what you've seen. If that weren't enough, I would have lost my brown hat. Don't you see it's the old us, the contiguous plurality of one, the meshing of dual symbiosis, the unity of connubial cantaloni?
Oh, golly, I've missed your vocabulary.
Oh, excuse me, I didn't know you were busy. But there's a customer in there who wants to know what's in the pate. I didn't want to tell him goose grease, so I thought I should ask you.
Oh, here you are, Miss class. Inside, you won't hustle booze, huh? But out here, you go bananas fooling around in the alley, huh? Why don't you knock it off, Cicely? You're taking all the starch out of this guy's apron. Boots?
Crazy broad, you. Remember the old days in the cafeteria on 8th Avenue? All the leftovers you could eat for 37 cents. Remember that?
Oh, yes, I remember.
Two-way Everly's on a shingle. Side is floor. Turn bay on a rat. Beat it down. Hold bay on. Open heart.
Get some water. She's going bananas. Nobody could ever order like you, Bubbles. Every time you called one of those orders out, you woke up everybody in the neighborhood with that crazy tingle body of yours when you walked.
Nobody could ever fill an order like you could.
Excuse me, do you love him?
Oh, well, I used to, but that was before I loved him.
And do you love her?
No. Get this, folks. I love you. I'm weird that way.
But how could you love me, Ernest? I love him.
Yes, and I love you, and she loves me, and you love her.
Oh, what's the use? We've all failed miserably.
It's their fault.
She's right, you know. You men will never change.
Hey, how about some service? I've been waiting for my lobster for a half an hour.
Why don't you get a hot bath?
Around here. I ordered a gin gimlet 20 minutes ago. How about some service?
Grace, it's you.
I bet you aren't going to get the line. Look at this, huh, folks? Two clowns in love. Bob, Ted, Carol, and Alice. Two buildings on a hike. Why don't you sit out there if you enjoy it?
How are the children?
I thought the children were with you.
Maybe one of you guys ate the kids. Everybody dance. Lullaby of Broadway was full of love.